Since this year, Sébastien Soriano is the new head of RCEP. Thank you to be here.
Nice to be there also. Yeah.
So my first question will be about legal alternative to preserve innovation in one side and in the other side to preserve also telco companies. The thing is, they need each other right now.
Yes, totally. I think that telco and digital market player are in complementary markets, so they have to live, together. And the first thing that we have to do to protect innovation is to do nothing, actually, because the main risk if we begin to intervene in an emerging market is to do something stupid and then to deter innovation. So when we talk about innovation and regulation, we have to be very modest and we have to be very careful in order to not artificially protect the incumbents and the present market players.
Yes. So how are you going to run the operation of regulation in the 28 countries in Europe with the European Commission?
Yeah, that's a very important question, because actually networks, you know, fixed networks that bring telephony services or access to the internet, and mobile networks are local. You know, you have to put antennas on the on platforms and roofs and so forth. You have to put wire lines underground. So it's local. So you need to have local and national authorities that regulates these facilities. But services are more and more worldwide. At the beginning, you know, you had 28 different telephony services. Today, you can have, I don't know, Skype, for instance, that can run over the 28 telephone and fixed network in the European Union. So I think that we really have to work together within the European Union, within the BEREC, which is the body of European regulator for electronic communication, which gather the 28 European regulator. We have to work together to harmonize our regulation at the service layer. You know, I think that's the great challenge.
And we talk about a lot about internet neutrality, but about networks. But how about infrastructure? You just mentioned Skype, but there is a lot of infrastructure made by the US, made by the other European leaders. How do you manage the neutrality with platform?
I think we are talking about very different things. And I think we don't have to confuse the question of net neutrality and platform neutrality. Net neutrality is a very quite clear concept. It is the idea that every IP packet within the networks must be treated in the same way, and that telecom operators don't have to micromanage the way the internet is running, and don't discriminate between such and such service on commercial base. So that's a quite clear concept, and actually this concept existed already in the post networks. So it's not really new. The idea is to keep on guaranteeing this neutrality of the networks in the internet world. The question of the platform is really not so clear. The idea is, well, we see that there are very big platforms that are like bottlenecks in the digital economy today. If you are a startup, you want to develop an application, you have to make it agreed by some kind of platform. You are an SME, you want to launch a website and to be well referred by Google. You can, for instance, buy this sponsored links on the AdWords or AdSense service. You really depend on this platform. So we see that there are new bottlenecks and that there is a question about how to guarantee real access for everybody and on an objective way to these new bottlenecks. But it's quite different, and I think we have many work to do before imposing any rule to this platform, because it's complex, it's moving, and it's a rich challenge for all regulators, competition regulators, sectorial regulation regulators, national regulators, EU regulators. We really have to work together to define the real and the correct answer to this very important problem.
So yes, in fact, when you're saying this, I'm just thinking about Google in US who are providing network. In fact, in Europe, it would be not possible because of this legal condition, because infrastructure cannot be also the network provider?
That's an interesting question. Actually, we don't forbid to a content player to roll out network. Everybody can roll out network. But if you roll out network and if you provide internet, you have to provide all internet. So, for instance, actually, what Facebook is developing in, you know, emerging countries to give an internet limited to Facebook, I think it couldn't match with the EU rules that we are currently implementing on the net neutrality. So I think this wouldn't work. But generally speaking, nothing forbids Facebook, Google, Apple, or anyone to roll out a network in Europe. Everybody can roll out a network, but there are specific rules to respect.
We keep that in mind. You were saying on stage that, I'm quoting, we don't want to deter innovation, we want to enable it. Is there a fight between innovation and regulation?
Well, I think if there is a fight, I think that innovation must win. Clearly, and we have to build a really pro-innovation, pro-business regulation. And that is very important because what we are seeing is that there is a competition between every country, every continent in the whole world, you know, to have startups and to make them grow, to become real innovative giants. And it would really be a pity if we define in Europe regulations that would deter innovation and that would make impossible for European startups to become internet major giants. So I think clearly our regulation must be pro-innovation. It must be in our DNA.
Thank you very much.